Okay. Christopher, you can start. You, Christopher?
Yes.
All right. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me. My name is Chris Coleman. I'm a member of the Texas Army National Guard. I serve out of North Fort Hood at Mates in Gatesville. I come here today to speak for First Lieutenant Patrick Cook of the 49th Transportation Battalion, Fort Hood, Texas. He was a victim of the Fort Hood current shooting. He wrote a letter, and he would like for y'all to hear it.
Be happy to hear it.
To my friends, fellow Texans, brothers in arms, members of the committee, and everyone within the sound of my voice, greetings. My name is First Lieutenant Patrick Cook of the 49th Transportation Battalion, Fort Hood, Texas. And this past Wednesday, I found myself trapped in an enclosed room with 14 of my fellow soldiers, one of whom was barricading the door against a madman with a 45 pistol when he was fatally shot. Through what I can only describe as a miracle, he somehow found enough strength to continue pushing against the door until the shooter gave up and went elsewhere, at which time he collapsed. Nearly a week later, I can still taste his blood in my mouth from when I and my comrades breathed the air into his lungs for 20 long minutes while we waited for a response from the authorities. This soldier's name was Sergeant First Class Daniel Ferguson, and his sacrifice loaned me the rest of my life to tell this story. But I write to you today not to memorialize this brave soldier nor to tell a war story about how we made the best of a losing situation, but to express the part of the story that in some high positions of power clearly do not want told. I knew this was going to happen. I had been saying it for 5 years that Fort Hood was a tinderbox for another massacre waiting to happen. It had to happen because our betters failed to learn the obvious lesson of 5 years ago. Worse yet, I know it will happen again. More will die, more will be wounded, more families will be torn apart needlessly. It happened again, and it will happen again because Fort Hood is a gun-free zone. When the first shots rang out, my hand reached for my belt for something that wasn't there, something that could have put a stop to the bloodshed, could have made it merely an ugly incident instead of the horrific massacre that I will surely remember the darkest 20 minutes of my life. Stripped of my God-given right to arm myself, the only defensive posture I had left was to lie prostrate on the ground and wait to die. As the shooter kicked at the door, I remember telling myself, "Oh well, this is it." It is beneath human dignity to experience the utter helplessness I felt that day. I cannot abide the thought that anyone should ever have to feel that again. At the point-blank range at which this shooting occurred, anyone with an M9 and some basic instruction could have ended the mayhem as quickly as it began. An MP by trade and CHL holder, I am convinced that the concealed weapons would have stopped it, but open-carried sidearms like the ones carried in law enforcement capacity could have prevented entirely. Instead, many more died because of the fatally misguided restrictions on the carrying of arms, which obviously the madman did not respect. I shall conclude by restating my warning. This will happen again and again until we learn the lesson that suppressing the bearing of arms doesn't prevent horrific crimes, it invites them. To those of you who hold elected offices, if you hear nothing else I have told you, hear this. You have the power to stop the next massacre from happening. You have an opportunity to restore the sacred right to bear arms, which has been either stripped entirely or unjustly relegated to the poor substitute of a probationary government-issued privilege. For God's sake, do the right thing. Thank you for your attention, and good day. That is his letter. I would like to say one last thing, that I served my country for 12 months in Iraq. I think it is an atrocity for my country to tell me that I can carry a gun in war for 12 months to defend my country, but I can't be trusted with it here back at home. It's a disgrace. Thank you.
Thank you for the letter. The fellow that wrote this letter, does he like wish to remain anonymous or something?
No, they didn't tell me he wished to remain anonymous.
Because it's not signed. Oh, no, it is up here. I'm sorry, Patrick Cook. Okay. Was he injured?
No, sir, he was not. But he gave CPR
to one of the fatalities.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. That's a very powerful letter.